Okay, now you gotta remember, like, when the dealer was getting started, I mean, like, most everybody now assumes you go to a concert and you get a big stack of amplifiers and a big stack of PA and a light show going all over. I mean, and you're lucky if we got the amps turned on, you know, and it was like, to just get a decent sound, we used to have to go make one the day of the show. We'd go by the music store and pick stuff. So, like, basically, there was a simpler, direct show we set up. You know, they were getting a PA in that worked pretty regularly. It had some buzzes and hums in it, but more or less getting us in a comfortable position to just go ahead and play. And it wasn't quite as complicated. We're not talking about like a Kiss concert now. We're just talking about everybody coming, having a good time, and listening to the songs and digging the music and really dancing around and really enjoying it. But we used to have many people hand draw up many of the posters and stuff. Could have been Toulouse-Lautrec doing that if we'd been another time, another era. Just the local artists doing things, contributing their 2 cents or their art into the pile to make things kind of feel fun and put a nice air to it. It's almost like something out of Mickey Rooney and Judy Garland. Hey, let's put on a play. I'll do the painting. I'll do the sets. Oh, I'll make the posters. Okay, yay, we'll have a show and we'll dance and sing. What you miss most now is you realize now that it's gone, that there's no little funky place to go out. I mean, you can't even go in some of these places that says proper dress. You gonna go in there and hear me? I mean, if I didn't play there, I couldn't get in. So I think that's the kind of thing, you know, hopping in the pickup with a six pack on the seat and your Levi's and your t-shirt, and you're gonna drop on down to see get a little beef jerky and bop on down to the Armadillo and see what's going on. That kind of thing you don't do, you know. Call over. Could I have reservations for 4, please? We believe we'll be coming over this evening. What should we wear? What is the attire? Oh, wear the Gene Autry clothes? All right, we'll be there in a little while. See you later. You know, that's probably what we miss.
Last dance at the Dillon.
A new band, Bojangles, and a dance for you. Worn out shoes, silver hair, a ragged shirt, and baggy pants. We did the old soft shoe. We jumped so high, jumped so high. Then he'd lightly touch down.
At the time I was writing it, I was kind of into some Dylan Thomas, reading Dylan Thomas and his internal rhymes. The down by the round brown sea came tumbling down, de bound, de boom, boom, all those internal things. And I'd heard him speak on a couple of records and Under Milkwood and those kind of things. I thought, God, what a great scam. Get a whiskey glass in one hand and take over the bar. Down by the round brown stuff. I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you, Ben. So I kind of just took it my own way, and it came out internal rhymes, and it just happened to be about a dancer, and the lyrics happened to dance. And I was into 3/4 time, which is, mine is really 6/8, kind of came out dancing about a dancer, and that's kind of what made it all happen. And probably the biggest reason it's as big a hit as it is that other people in show business like to sing a song about show business. So they picked it up. In other words, more people in show business sang it than would normally have had for any other song because it was about show business. So that's kind of it. Kind of helped it along, I think. Otherwise, I have no idea.